A committee examining the Voice to Parliament referendum will hold hearings across the country this week before recommending any changes to the proposed amendment. Hearings will be held against a backdrop of animosity around the response to child abuse in the Northern Territory.
A committee of 13 from across the political landscape have commenced their month-long inquiry into the Voice to Parliament proposal.
Point on bipartisanship. It's been so difficult. Let's do the hard work to try and get the wording as good as we can.
Jesuit priest Father Frank Brennan made one of the 19 submissions on the opening day of hearings. A long-time advocate for Indigenous recognition, he is holding back his support for the Yes campaign until the wording of a proposed amendment is narrowed.
Why die in a ditch on keeping executive government rather than just ministers and parliament in there?
He argues narrowing the Voice remit to advise parliament and ministers, not parliament and the executive government, would remove any legal uncertainty and improve the referendum's chances of success.
What you want is wording which is sufficiently precise, which can bring the Andrew Braggs, the Julian Leases of this world on board.
Further committee hearings will be held in Orange, Cairns, Perth and Canberra in the weeks ahead. It will report back with any suggested changes after the budget in May.
I know that the representatives on that inquiry will do what they can to find a pathway through.
An area that hasn't been included on the listening tour is Alice Springs, where one opposition senator believes the sexual abuse of minors is so rampant, responsibility for child protection should be taken out of territory hands.
Is if we put the lives and the responsibility of children into the federal arena, that's a referendum I could get behind.
Jacinta Nampajimpa-Price, a front-runner to become the Coalition's next spokesperson on Indigenous affairs, went further, accusing the agency responsible for child safety in the territory of placing vulnerable children back in the hands of their abusers.
Pediatricians, child psychologists are saying to them, do not put these children back in these dysfunctional circumstances, and yet are doing that.
Kinship care is not a system that places children back into communities or into households with their perpetrators. This is classic drop a bomb, walk away.
Senator Price tells Sky News she stands by her claims. Cameron Redden, Sky News, Canberra.